When creating content for your course, you're often going to be using both images and text together. But formatting the two so that they look right together can be a challenge. Here, if you look below at the news item, you see that I've added a photograph. Now, if I had some text that I wanted to add, and I do have some text that I've copied to my clipboard, I will paste it with Command-V or Control-V, and you can see it appears below. Now, if I wanted to appear beside, you'd think I could just go here and hit back. But this is what it would look like. And that's because this image is like one gigantic character that goes from here to here. It doesn't know to treat both these things separately. There is a way to arrange both the text and the images so that it looks a little bit better and gives you a little bit better control over how the text is going to line up with the image. And you do that using tables. So if I click down here, and this button right here says Insert a New Table. If I click it, I have choices how many columns and how many rows I want to use in my table. Well, I'm going to have two columns, and I'm just going to make one row here. And if you go down to Border, if you have a number there, just make sure you type in 0. Now, what this is going to do is it's going to create a table that has no border around it. It's going to be invisible. And this is good because we don't necessarily want the table to be seen. We just want to use the table to align both the text and the images the way we want them. So if I go down here and I hit Insert, it will create a table. And you can see it's currently blinking in one of the cells of the table. And I'm just going to press the space bar a couple of times just to make that a little bit larger. And you'll see why in a second. Now, I want the picture to be on one side, on the left, and I want the text to be on another. So I can just grab this picture and drag it down until it's inside that first cell. And if I let go, now it's inside the cell. And the reason I had those extra couple of spaces is sometimes it's tricky to get it in exactly where you want it. Now I can delete those two spaces. Now I'm going to move my text. Another way to move it into the cell is to select it, go Control X or Command X if you're using a Mac, click on the cell, and then go Control V or Command V on a Mac. And now you can see I have my text centered in my photograph. And this is really what I want. And although it looks like there's an outline to this table, this is just to show me where the different cells are. If I were to save this and go out to look at it, you could see that no table borders are visible. By using text and images together, you can really create some dynamic looking content for your course. But sometimes those two elements need help playing nicely together. That's why you can use tables with invisible borders to arrange the layout of both the text and the images so they appear exactly as you want them to appear. But images aren't the end of what you can add to your content in your course. You can embed videos from a site like YouTube or other content from the web into your course posts or content or news items, and I'll show you how to do that in the next video.